Hello everyone, I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to start with the first poem of book Beehive. We are going to have a look on the explanation of the poem, the literary devices of the poem, rhyming scheme and hard words. So here we are starting. The name of the poem is The Road Not Taken, written by Robert Frost. First we are going to look some information about Robert Frost. Robert Frost was an American poet and his work initially published in England and in America. He born in San Francisco, USA, and he wrote many poems like The Road Not Taken, Stopping by Boats on a Snowy Evening, Mending Wall, and awards he got are Pulitzer Prize, USA Poet Laureate, and many more. He was a natural poet. He loves to write poem on the natural scene. So here one of his poem we are going to look at, The Road Not Taken. So this is the poem, The Road Not Taken. This is well known poem about making choices and the choices that shapes a life, a future life. So Robert Frost is addressing to each and every person, because every person has to gone through a condition in his life when he is having two ways to take the decision, and very carefully, with very intelligence, he has to take the decision to choose one path. So explanation, before giving explanation, I just summarize this poem that here two roads symbolizes two ways of every person's life. But at one time, the person has to walk on only one path. He cannot walk at one time on two paths. He has to choose one path, and that path leads to his future. So he has to make the intelligence decision before going ahead on any path, because that is going to make his future. So the explanation of the poem, the two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both. Now diverged is called separated in different direction, and yellow wood is something, the forest having decaying leaves, dry leaves or yellow leaves. Okay, so poet is saying once a poet was walking down on a road, and then he has to stop because in front of him there was a diversion, means two roads were there that were going in different direction. As you can see in the picture, two roads were going in different directions. The poet says that he has to take only one road, but these two roads are symbolizes two decisions in the life. And be one traveler, long I stood and looked down one as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. Now, poet is in the form of traveler. He was standing as a traveler and he was looking on which road he has to go. And the other road was bent in undergrowth. Undergrowth is called the forest full of green leaves and grassy area. So just opposite of the yellow wood. Yellow wood means the forest is having no green leaves, and undergrowth means the forest having full of green leaves and grassy area. So two roads in front of him. One road was going towards yellow wood, the forest without leaf, and one road was going towards the forest full of green leaves. Now he was standing before those two roads and thinking on which road he has to take ahead his way. Now here, when we see the path in the curved area, then one of the path may be hidden and one of the path may be open in front of us. Then, but we have to choose only one of them, and that's why we have to think and take our time and think about the pros and cons. Pros and cons means about the benefit and the losses we are going to face on heading on any of the path. So we have to make a decision very carefully which path we have to take. So this time poet was standing in front of two roads and he has to take the decision on which path he has to go, and this was about making his decision, and that is going to affect his future. Now the rhyme scheme in this stanza is A B A A B. Rhyme scheme shows the rhyming part of that is shown by the last word of each line, like here would, both, stood, could, and growth. These are the last word of each line decides the rhyming scheme. So the rhyming scheme of this stanza is A B A A B. Now we came on the literary device of this stanza. Now literary device that is present is anaphora. Now anaphora is something when any of this word is coming again and again in the line repeatedly. Like here you can see, and sorry, I could not travel both. Again in the third line, and be one traveler long I stood. Again in fourth line, and looked down one as far as I could. Now you can see line number 2, 3, and 4. They are starting with the same word A and D end. So here the repetition of the word and is here. So the literary device will be anaphora. So anaphora means when the same word is repeated in the beginning of the continuous line, then the device will be anaphora. Now coming on the second stanza, then look the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim. Now fair means good as the other one, means one is good and the other is also good, and claim is called the better option. So here poet was looking on one path for a long time and he was deciding on which path he has to start walking on. Then he says just as fair. So he felt that both the paths, means if the one path is good, then another path is also good. That was equally good. And he started walking on one of them. Because it was grassy and wanted wear. Now grassy is called something that full of grass, and wanted wear that is called not used. Okay, so one of the path was grassy, full of grass, and that was not used by many people. So he adds that maybe he felt the path was a better option, means the grassy path way, that was the better option because this is not used by many persons. Many persons are not walked on this path earlier. Then wanted wear is something for him, means he want to go on that path that is not used by many people. Though, as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. Now, both the paths is having the similar and worn out. Means it was looking, one of the path was grassy and one of the path was with the decaying or with the yellow leaves, but both the paths were looking similar. And this is symbolizing with our life when we have to take a path, but both the paths were looking same. Means when you start walking any path, how can you know to which extent this path will go? Means when we are going on one path and after going so much after covering the distance, which type of disadvantage, which type of benefits, which type of problems and challenges we have to face, one cannot know until he start moving on that path. Okay, so one of the path you have to take, you have to walk on, only then you are going to realize about the benefits, about the problems, about the challenges you are going to face by walking on that path. So we have to think very carefully to choose a better option that on which we have to start our journey. Now again, the rhyme scheme in this stanza is A B A A B. Means the rhyme scheme or of this poem in all the stanza is same, like fair, claim, wear, there, same. The last word of each line decides the rhyme scheme of the poem. Now literary devices is alliteration. Now alliteration is something when the repetition of the consonant word is there. Now you can see in fourth line, though as for that, the passing there. Now see, T is a consonant, okay, and here in this line T is repeated again and again. Though started with T, that started with T, The is started with T and there started with T means repetition of T consonant is four times there in this line. That's why we are having literary devices alliteration. Okay, so what is alliteration? When any consonant letter is repeated again and again in a line, then the literary device will be alliteration. Fine. Now, stanza number 3, and both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Now, trodden is called, means many of the person walked over that. That's why that path became walked over. Means it was looking like that many of the persons had gone through this way. So poet says both the paths were similar from the starting in the morning when you are standing, and both had the leaves on them, and that has stepped on them as we are still green in color. Means means two paths were there. Okay, suppose two paths were there. One of the paths is having green leaves and one of the paths is having dry or yellow leaves. Now, from this condition, what can you assess? You can assess means the green part is there, means less people walked on that. That's why it still remained green. And the yellow leaves part means so many people's walked on that way. That's why leaves became crushed and became dried. Okay. We can simply take out this meaning, means the decaying part, the dry leaves path has been chosen by many people, but whereas the green leaves path is chosen by less people. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. Now he's saying he has to decide that he would take one path and keep the other path for another day. Although he knew that the one path leads to another way. Obviously, if there are two paths, means one of the path will going in different direction and another path will go in different direction. So on this day, he decided that today I'm going on one path, but I can make mine to take another path for another day. Means he is just keeping one of the decision in a spare. Means two decisions were there and he has some time to take. First I will take this decision for some time and I am also come back to take the decision to have a look on the another decision like this. This line is symbolizing like this. Now he knew that he could now go back to the choice that he had made. Means if I have taken one decision on time, okay, especially here time is very much forced, time is very much focused. Means if you have, so you are in the starting, in the childhood or in the young age, you have much time to take your decision. And if you are not finding yourself comfortable or in the hope of getting success on one decision, you have the time to come back on the second path. But if you are taking this decision very late, then you are going to have no time. But here poet is saying, yes, I am having time, so I am leading on one path, but if I am not going to find this path according to me, then I have the time and I will come back to on another path. Similarly, even our life, when we have to choose an option, we must keep moving ahead, and without thinking too much, without wasting a time, we have to take the decision. We have to save our time so that if that path is not going to suitable for us, we can come back on the another path. Now, rhyme scheme in this stanza is same. A, B, A, A, B. That decided why the words of the line, that is lay, black, day, way and back. The last word of each line makes the rhyme scheme of the poem. Now literary device again is alliteration. Means the consonant word, consonant letter that is going to be repeated again and again. And in this line we can see in the third line, oh, I kept the first for another day. Means when the same consonant letter is repeated continuously in different words. Here you can see first started with F and for started from F again means F is consonant letter, and F and F continuously coming in one line, so device is alliteration. Now last stanza of the poem, I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Now sigh is called long breathe, and hence means in future. Ages and ages are here showing the time, okay. So a poet is saying that somewhere in future he is going to take a deep breath and say that once upon a time we reached, or I reached on such a point of life that I'm going to have the decisions, and I have to take only one decision. Means two ways were there in front of me, I have to choose one, and that way will decide my complete future. So in simple way, when you are now on the stage, when taking decision time has gone, when you have to take the decision, that time has gone. Now you are in the time when you can say yourself with a long breath that yes, I have chosen the path that is chosen by lesser number of the people, okay, and that's why I have decided my future myself. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Poet was standing on two roads. I told you one of the road is having the decaying leaves, yellow leaves path, and one path was full of green leaves. So it was showing green leaves path were chosen by lesser number people. Okay, so which path poet had decided? The path full of green leaves that was chosen by less number of people. The so poet chose that path. Okay, so poet was telling I chosen this path, and that now that's why I am here, and that path had decided my future. Now this is the thing chosen by the poet, but in symbolic way, indirectly poet was saying that you are going to make your choice, and that choice is going to make your future. Okay, so this is a type of very powerful message for each and every human being, that you have to become very wise and very careful when you have to make your choice, because at that time the time is in your hand. So utilize the time, show your intelligence to take the right decision of your life, okay, because the complete future is depend on your that choice that you are making today. Okay, the decision you are going to make today, your future, your tomorrow is going to be depend on that. Now again, rhyme scheme is same in this stanza also, like sigh, hence, I, by, and difference. The last word of each line make the rhyme scheme of this poem, A B A A B. Again, the literary devices in this literary devices is called repetition here. Repetition simple means repetition, alliteration. In the last stanza we have done alliteration, that was also repetition, but that was the repetition of consonant letter, means only one letter. But repetition device, literary device in the sense of repeating of words. Okay, so here which words, which two words or three words are repeating? See, in line number two, somewhere ages and ages hence. Now you can see ages came at two places. Then the literary devices simply will be repetition. Ages and ages. Okay, so literary device is present in the second line of the last stanza, that is repetition. Here we have reached the glossary part of the poem. Hard word of each stanza I wrote down at one places. You can note down in your notebook, and with the help of these, the meaning of these hard words, try to summarize the poem. Okay, be very careful, and keep the literary devices and rhyme scheme in your mind whenever you are making the explanation of the poem, so that you can understand the poem in a better way. Now glossary is diverged, that is called separated in different direction. Yellow wood means forest with decaying leaves. Undergrowth, dense growth of plant. Fear, as good as other one. Claim means better option. Grassy, unused. Unwanted wear, that is means not used. Trodden means walked over. Sigh means deep breath. Hence means in the future. So I hope you all understood the explanation of the poem in a better way. Now that's it for now, and we meet again.